So in this video, we are going to talk about how search engine works. Hello friends, I'm Shivani Goyal. Welcome in WS Cube Time. So let's start with the new topic on SEO module, that is how search engine work. In this module, we are going to discuss about what is search engine, what is crawling, what is indexing, what is your crawl budget, and how to optimize your crawl budget. Okay, so let's start with a brief definition on search engine. What search engine is? So a search engine is a software program that helps people find the information they are looking for online using keyword or the phrases. Okay, example of the search engines are just like your Google, Bing, Yahoo. You can use these search engines to figure out any particular information you want to get. Okay, so these search engines can store information about trillions of the web pages in an organized format. Okay, so basically that is the search engine. And now we have to know how the search engine work. When you search any particular query, then what are the backend activities happening on the search engine? Because just by knowing that, here we can work on this way. Now we have three components of search engine. First one is your query engine, which proceed your query to your crawler, which proceed your query to your search engine database just to figure out that information. Next is your crawler, which can read every single information from your website. And next one is indexer, which can index your website. Okay. Next is your crawling. What is this crawling here? Crawling basically means crawling is reading content on the web pages and storing that information in a database. So what happened here? Let's suppose this is your website. Okay. And on your website, you can add multiple information there. Information in the form of text, in the form of images, in the form of video. Okay. So whatever be the information you added in your website, here we have one web crawler, or you can also say web spider. Okay, so your web crawler or web spider visit on your website, or any particular seed URL you mentioned there, any particular URL queue in your web page. Okay, they can visit there and crawl every single information fetched with the help of internet here, and then extract that information and save this information in your database. Okay, so this is the use of crawling here. In case of crawling, let's suppose if any web link is available in your web page. Okay, so how your Google crawler is going to work? They first visit your website, read your content, again they found one link here, then they again visit on that particular link page and also read all the information available here. So this is the functioning of crawler here. Now the web crawler explores the web page based on some policies. What are these policies? Let's figure out. First of all, we have one selection policy. According to the selection policy, crawler decide which page it should download and which it should not. Next we have revisit policy. Revisit policy means that crawler schedule the time when it should reopen the web page and added the changes in its settings. Okay, let's suppose if this is your website, web crawler visit to your website and read every single information. Okay, and after some days, if you do any change in your web page, in that case, here Google crawler again visit to your website and again crawl all the recommended added changes which you've done in your website and store that changes in their database. Okay, next we have parallelization policy. In case of parallelization policy, crawlers use multiple processes at once to explore the links known as distributed crawling here. So what happened in that case here? Let's suppose this is your website A. Okay, and your website A link is mentioned in website B. This is the link of website A here. And again, your website link is mentioned in the website C here. That is the link of website A. Okay, so what happened here? When Google crawler read your website, they can read every single content available in your website here. And again, when web crawler read information of the V, then they can also find your website link. And then they again visit to your website with the help of this particular link and again read all the information available in this particular web page. Okay, and the same activity they do with the help of C. When they read information from website C, then they can also get your link from here and they can also visit your website with the help of this particular link. Okay, so by this way, they can read your website content with the help of multiple sources here. So this is known as multiple process and distributed crawling. Okay, next we have politeness policy. In case of politeness, what happened here? We have a term known as crawl delay. Okay, so what is this crawl delay means? When Google crawler downloads any information from your web page, then they just take a pause of some millisecond, and that millisecond pause is known as crawl delay here. Okay, that is implemented in which the crawler has to wait for a few seconds after it downloads some data from the website. Okay, so these are the policies we have in case of crawling. Next we have how the crawling works. See, we have a search engine here. Let's suppose Google is your search engine. When someone put any query here, any query in the search engine, okay, then what happened here? Your web spider or your web crawler visit to your website, read every single web page, crawl your website, copy the information in your website and store that information in the data. Okay, and when user put any information there, then that information is figured out from this database and display the result from this database to the user. So this is how your crawler works. Okay, after crawling, next we have indexing. Okay, as Google crawler or your search engine crawler crawl every information from your website, that after crawling your information, now the next step is to do indexing. What indexing means? Indexing is just like you can do indexing of your book. Okay, let's suppose if you want to figure out any particular topic from this book. Okay, now what approach you can do? First, you will start from your search page and start continue reading all the topics here, or you can simply look at your index, figure out that particular topic corresponding to this, figure out your page, simply visit that page number and find your information. Okay, so this is the easiest step here, like simply look at your index and visit to that particular page. The same thing happens in the Google, in your search engine. In your search engine database, we have lot of information there. Okay, so just to fetch your user's query from that particular database, it is really difficult. So that's why here search engine do indexing on the basis of keywords here. Okay, when someone search for any particular query, then corresponding to their query, we can check their relevant keyword, and then that particular query or information will reflect to your user. Okay, so after the baby search engine crawl all over the internet, it creates an index of all the web pages it finds in its way. Okay, we have so many factors which contribute to create an efficient indexing system for a search engine. First, we have storage information used by the indexer. Okay, next we have your indexer size. What is the size of your indexer? Third is the ability to quickly find the document containing the searched keyword here. Okay, so these are the factors which are responsible for the efficiency and reliability of an index. Okay, this is how your indexing happens. Here we have a user. User do any search query, and search query is passed with the help of your query engine. Okay, and here we have some HTML pages, or you can say your web pages. Web pages are the pages of your website. Okay, then your indexer will get keywords from your web pages. Your keywords from web pages. Okay, After fetching your keyword, they store these keywords in the form of indexing to their index file or repository. Okay, what happened here? Let's suppose if your website working on same keyword, another website that's also working on same keyword. In that case, our indexer provide them ranking. Like this particular keyword will rank first, this particular keyword will rank second. On the basis of that, they add these keywords in their repository, and when user put any query, then your query engine look at in the index file and get list of the match pages here and show result page to your users. Okay, whatever be the relevant result page, relevant information your user want to get, that information will be visible to your users here. Okay, next we have two type of indexing. One is your forward index and next one is your backward index. So what is this? See, in case of forward index, in these type of indexes, all the keywords present in a document are stored. Okay, what happened here? These are the keywords. Let's suppose we have document 1, and in our document 1 we have these keywords like the, cow, seeds, moo. So let's suppose these are the keywords here. Okay, again for document 2 these are the keywords we have. Again for document 3 we have these keywords. So this is the one form of indexing. Next we have reverse index. What is this reverse index? In that case, the forward indexers are stored and converted to reverse index, in which each document containing a specific keyword and is put together with other document containing that keyword. What happened here? Here, in case of forward, we have primary segment is our document. Like we can check our particular keyword in document here. Next we have, in case of reverse index, we have keyword here, and we can figure out the document corresponding to that keyword here. Let's suppose here we have a keyword the, so corresponding to that keyword we have these document here. Okay, so this is known as reverse indexing. Okay, we are done with our indexing part. Now, so the question is how search engine work. So how it's working, here we have user. When user put any query, then with the help of ranking algorithm, that query will fetch from the database, and your web spider crawl every single information from the web page and then do indexing, and after doing indexing they store it in the database. Okay, and that fetch data up in your index file, and then that will send to your user. So this is how your search engine works. Next is crawl budget. So what is this crawl budget here? The number of time a search engine spider crawl your website in a given allotted time is what we call your crawl budget. Okay, let's suppose this is your website, Google crawler visit your website first time and crawl every single information. Okay, when you are doing some changes in your website, again web crawler visit to your website, crawl every single information. In that case, here you can see that your crawl budget is 2, because 2 times your web spider will visit on your website. Okay, so which is known as crawl budget. Now we have to optimize your crawl budget so that our website will rank on our search engine first page. Okay, for this we have to opt some strategies here. So what are these strategies? In this, you have to avoid using your rich media files, that is your flash rich media. In that case, you have to build your internal links and the external links. What is internal linking here? Here you can see that, let's suppose this is your home page. Then we have your category page inside your home page. And all these pages are interconnected to each other. Okay, let's suppose if your Google crawler will read information from this particular page, then they can also figure out the link of these pages, and they can again visit these pages and read every single information available on these pages. So this is how your internal linking help your search engine spider to read all the information from your website. So internal link inform Google to other relevant pages on your website, and even the keywords for which you would like them to rank. So internal linking helps point boards to key pages much faster. That's why we have to do internal linking to optimize our crawl budget. Next, we have external link. In case of external link, these links help search engine understand the context of the pages as well as providing a good user experience. In that case, what happened here? Let's suppose this is your website, and in your website, let's suppose we have a link which redirects your website to external link. Okay, in that case, you can tell your Google Spider about this particular website. They can again visit that website and read all the single information available on that website here. Okay, next we have to make use of our social channel. That will also help you to rank your website faster on your search engine result page. So these are the ways you can optimize your crawl budget. Okay, so in this video we will cover how your search engine working, and in our more upcoming video we will learn more about SEO. So thank you so much for watching this video.